up, dirty plant hoes and all my official and unofficial dirty plant enthusiasts out there. My name is Rachel. This is Heart-Shaped Leaf. You know what today's video is going to be about? Exactly what you guys wanted it to be about. Do you want to be a shower and a grower? Well, I'm going to tell you how today. We are going to talk about my 10 best tips.
How many tips do I have?
10. 10 tips to get bigger leaves on all your indoor tropical houseplants. So before we get started with like tips and tricks and things like that, I want to just say you can skip all of this and just buy a big ass plant. If you bought something like this, boom, you have big leaves. Congratulations, you win. You're done.
You did it! Congratulations!
But this video is more along the lines for people who want to buy a particular type of houseplant and they want to grow it to have big leaves in game style. Did you know that this channel has memberships now? That's crazy! If you want to support me, if you want to support this channel, you can hit the join button. That should be right down below on this video. But if it's not, you can always type in my URL on YouTube/join. So if you were my girlfriend, and you came over to my house and you were like,
tell me what it's gonna take for me to get some big leaves like your leaves. I want leaves like your leaves.
And I would say, Karen, calm down. First of all, so let's start out with tip number one. Here's the first thing I would tell you. You have to pick a plant with potential. If you pick a plant that just doesn't have a large growth habit, if you pick a plant that no matter what you do, it's never gonna get a leaf larger than, you know, yay big, then you're cutting your nose off to spite your face. Pick a plant that you know at full maturity has the capability of having large leaves. Now that may seem silly to some of you, but some people are beginning plant collectors and they don't know which plants get large leaves at maturity and which plants will always have a short and more stubby growth habit. You should probably have a pretty good idea of the requirements of this plant before you order it or before you buy it. Not only should you know like its growth habit, but you should also know its needs and can you provide those needs. I'm guilty. I buy plants all the time. I don't know what the needs are. Don't do what I do. Do what I say. Number two, pick a healthy specimen. Getting bigger leaves takes time. There is no way around it. When you're buying a rehab plant or you're buying an import plant, those plants are going to take extra long to get to a large leaf stage like something like this. If you want to cut down the clock time between now and having big giant leaves, then you need to start out with a specimen that's really healthy, as big as you can find. Of course, that's not always the case. People buy babies all the time and they grow them up to be gigantic plants like what I've done. We're talking indoor gigantic, it's different. You need to consider your plant's ability to produce big leaves like it's almost like it's on a clock. And every time that you do something drastic to it, you're resetting the clock. You import a plant, if you buy a rehab plant, its clock is gonna be set back a bit. If you find a really, really nice, healthy, actively growing specimen somewhere and you buy that, you're definitely going to have bigger, larger leaves before someone who buys the other option. My next tip would be to get the appropriate medium for the plant that you're growing. Now, this is another do as I say, don't do as I do type of situation. If it's a philodendron, make sure that the soil is well draining. If it's an anthurium, make sure that the soil is well draining. Don't stunt your plant's growth by providing it with the wrong building blocks right off the bat. So I actually have a soil video and I'll be sure and link that down in the video description. So number four would be support is important. When you're potting up something like a climbing philodendron, if you know that this is a climbing plant and the leaves get larger because it's climbing up, what am I trying to say here? Don't ignore the fact that your plant wants to be on a pole. She wants it. She needs it. She's that kind of girl. If you ignore the fact that your plant needs a pole or you delay putting a pole in, then your plant's gonna suffer. The leaves that it puts out at the top are going to be miniaturized and it's definitely not going to feel stable. You need to provide this plant with the idea that it has found a tree, a friend, a buddy, that it is going to climb up. You're basically tricking it into thinking that it's in its natural environment. So don't forget your pole. Number five is all about watering. If you're torturing your plant and you're underwatering all the way up to the point of really, really, really stressing it out, and then you're watering, this is not really necessarily the type of behavior that's going to encourage this big, giant leaf growth, right? You've got to get on some sort of a pattern. I hate to say the word schedule because it feels wrong. You've got to get something figured out to where you're watering this plant the way it wants to be watered. Figure out what that particular plant that you have wants and keep it up, because the more you stress it out with either overwatering it, which causes root rot, which sets your clock back, or underwatering it, which causes crispy edges and ugly leaves, and which also will set your clock back. Do you need a watering stake? Get a watering stake. Do you need your boyfriend to help you out? Get your boyfriend to help you out. Whatever. Just make sure that you stay on somewhat of a schedule that this plant prefers, because the happier you're making this big boy, the happier you're making these plants, the bigger the leaves are going to get. It will always have to do with how old, how mature, how long you've had the plant, but these are tips that will help you to get there. Number six, fertilize. Fertilize, fertilize, fertilize. You have to fertilize your plant. You just have to. You cannot starve a plant that you're expecting to put out these good looking, massive, velvety, long leaves if you're not pulling your weight in the relationship, right? Are you worth growing big leaves for? Are you worth it? I don't care what kind of fertilizer you use. I would recommend dulling it down to half strength and that it should be a house plant type fertilizer. I use Miracle-Gro liquid fertilizer. I also use Miracle-Gro stakes in some of my plants, so I'm a Miracle-Gro girl, what can I say? And it seems to work really well, so if it ain't broke, don't fix it. Congratulations, you're the new CEO of the pest management department in your very own botanical garden. I know it sounds a little overwhelming. That's because it is a little overwhelming. Pests are going to set your clock back, and if you don't figure out how to get your pests under control, then you're not ever going to really get to the point where you're getting these large, mature, voluptuous leaves. I'm not saying you're not gonna have pests. You're
definitely gonna have pests. Definitely.
What I'm saying is that you need to start looking at pest management like what a botanical garden does. A botanical garden's main goal is usually to control the pest population and also prevent leaf damage. That's it, because they know they're going to have pests. You're not going to be using gnarly pesticides a lot of the time in your house. I hope you're not. But a pest-ridden plant is not going to produce the way you want it to produce. You need to know what works. You need to know why it works. And you should probably be doing some research into certain things. The reason why neem oil is so big in the plant community is because it works. There's lots and lots and lots of science behind the neem oil. I personally have a problem with the smell, so I try to get away with using other tactics. If you want to check out my spider mite video, you can check it out. I'll link it down below. I just try to treat the plants outside where I don't have to smell it because it makes me gag. I'm sorry if you like the smell. Damn, it's bad. No, cactus. So try not to get that overwhelming feeling of, oh my God, I got a pest. Oh my God, I got a pest. Oh my God. Because if you have enough plants, you're not going to have the bandwidth for that kind of freaking out every time a pest happens. You have to kindly, sortly start educating yourself because you're the new CEO. Number eight, up potting is important. A forgotten, lonely, neglected plant who you still manage to water, but you have not bumped it up into a bigger pot, is not going to exercise its full potential. It's just not. The only way that you're going to get the more mature growth, the more mature stem, the more mature everything, is if you're helping to mature the roots as well. You're giving them space to grow. You're helping them to say, oh, I have more room now. I have more ways to take up water. I have a bigger structure down here. You're sending cues and clues to the rest of the plant to say, hey, it is time. Let's put on a show. You always have to be keyed in. You have to read your plants. You gotta read your plants. You gotta read people. You gotta read your plants. Don't expect to get something awesome from a relationship that you're not putting the most into. Don't expect to get these huge leaves out of this plant that you're not pouring that much commitment into. If you want to see the big payoff, you really have to put in some effort. It's not going to happen overnight, and it's not magical. Number 9, keep track of your progress. Not because you have to, but because it's fun. For example, my Anthurium Ace of Spades, it's putting out a little bitty teeny tiny leaf. It's about this big right now. But I know that if I go over there with a measuring tape 3 or 4 times a day, you guys, this leaf is going to grow, and it will be measurable growth. It's fun. It's fun to measure your progress, and not only that, but you'll know also from measuring your progress whether or not the care that you're providing for your plant is paying off. Does that make sense? So if it really likes what you're doing and what you've been doing, it will continue to produce bigger leaves. If it doesn't like what you're doing, it's going to go backwards in time. It's going to reset its clock a bit. So if you notice you're getting smaller leaves with the care that you're giving it, change something. It's light oriented or fertilizer oriented, or you've got a pest problem that you maybe are unaware of, but it requires investigation. You need to be investigating the crime scenes at that point. You can take pictures, you can log your process, and it's really fun. It's fun to look back on. It's fun to look back on where your plant was last year, or where your plant was the year before that. And it's fun to anticipate what it might look like a year from now. Look, there's lots of stuff to stress out about. Write it all down. Which brings me to number 10. Don't stress out. It's gonna sound super woo-woo, but I think to a certain degree, plants can pick up your vibe. They can pick up when you're super stressed and you're really ninnying over them and you're poking them all the time and you're rubbing them too much and getting your skin oils all over them, and they can just pick up vibes, you know? That sounds so stupid. I feel like they can pick up vibes, okay? Don't stress out so much. Be cool. Do your best. Know that you're doing your best and take some solace in that. Watch for signs of improvement, and remember, this is supposed to be fun. Even if things don't turn out the way you want, cut it up. Make it do what you want to do. If my plants are acting up and I just get sick of it and I've just stressed myself, it's time to propagate, because I probably am going to have better luck starting over fresh rather than trying to struggle with this plant that's been giving me troubles. It's not a competition. Some people who have these gigantic leaves on these plants that you see on Instagram have been growing these plants for years. You want to buy a really big plant to start out with, that's a damn good way to get big ass leaves right off the bat. A lot of this stuff just takes time and it takes patience, and that's what it's probably going to require from you, is time and patience and love. Thank you so much for watching today's video. I hope that you liked my 10 tips for getting larger leaves on your indoor tropical houseplants. Don't forget to subscribe if you enjoyed today's content and give this video a like. Pretty please, because it helps us out with the algorithm. If you want some more content, or if you're feeling bored, you can always go over and hit up our sister station, Heart Shaped Leaves After Dark Podcast. I would like to say thank you so much to my official Dirty Plant Enthusiast members of my channel. I cannot believe that you guys hit the join button, and I am literally floating on cloud 9. I super duper duper appreciate it, and I'm excited to create content just for you guys. Just from a babies. From a little babies. It's actually pretty cool. I like it. So from my little heart to your little heart, we love you guys. Be sure to take care of yourselves and take care of each other. Peace out. Later, taters. Bye. I am burning. What's up, y'all? I'm here to give a big old shout out to all my new level 1 Dirty Plant Enthusiast members. We've got the plant channel, Cody, Rhiannon Chambers, Lady Musing, Heather Summers, My Clean Leaves, Katrin, Lara Juno, Dan Usantos, Christine Wisney, Nicholas Constant, Medusa's Mess, Jana Vieira, Pammy's Planty Things, Nadine Guzman, Tara Peterson, The Plants Meow, Sarah Jones, Lulu's Leaves, Diana Warner, Reagan Cornelius, Amanda Mervine, Jedi KCC, Darren Heppel, Chris, Tracy Buzzle, Seven Puggies, Caitlin 90, Lynn Therese, Kelly Hodgson, Plantastica, Christy D, Ace Cadet, Juan ZC, Chelsea Clifton, Mark Strahl, and Anna D. Thank you so much. We love you. Bye.